My name is Rebecca Braun here at Reach Yoga, and today we're offering a gentle yoga practice with a little bit of yin, lots of stretching, and a meditation at the end, so you'll feel great. And we're going to go ahead and start in reclining butterfly. So come to seated. You want the soles of your feet together. You have control over where you want your feet. If they're farther out, you're in diamond and the stretch is coming more in your outer thighs, and the closer you come into butterfly, and the stretch is in your inner thighs. So find a place that's comfortable for you, and then bring your hands behind you and surrender to the floor. And I will keep time on these poses, and this one will be about 5 minutes. I'll do most of the poses with you. One thing it helps me with cueing. So you want to start by becoming very heavy. Your legs, your knees will want to kind of lift up and become active. Just mentally tell your legs, your knees, your thighs to let go, as though you were going to fall asleep in this position. And then go ahead and bring one hand to your belly and one hand to your heart. And start to come inward. Start to let go of anything that's off of your mat. Any worries, thoughts. Try to come inward and become aware of your breathing. The way that your belly expands on the inhale. See if you can get a complete exhale. As a matter of fact, you might notice when your body breathes naturally without you manipulating in any way here in a still position, that there is a brief cessation, a brief pause at the end of each out-breath. Your body does this naturally, and it is known as a portal into stillness, the Buddha called it. A place where you can find stillness, a gap between your thinking, and kind of an anchor for meditation. And try to become present. In fact, you could try something that's called a presence meditation. Each time you exhale, imagine or say silently to yourself the word presence. And on the inhale, just allow stillness. So when you repeat that affirmation, that word presence, it's almost like a pearl dropping in a pool of water. And on the inhale, just watch the ripple in the water until it becomes still. And see if you can continue to do that. Presence. Each time your mind wanders, your thoughts come, and they will. See if you can notice, is that a thought that's stuck in the past. If it is, label it past and let it go. And come right back to that affirmation, that meditation presence. And maybe especially in these times, when thoughts come, you'll notice that it is of the future. Maybe worrying, planning, thinking about, trying to figure out your situation in the future. See if you can just label it future and watch it drift away. Come back to that affirmation presence. And now take an inhale and bring your thighs together. So bring your hands to your thighs, bring your feet, soles of your feet to the mat and your knees pointing upward. And then roll over to your left side. Take a nice inhale and on the exhale, come up to seated. And we'll come into half butterfly. So you're here in staff, and our inclination, kind of our instinct, is to flex the feet and become active as though we're at the gym. But see how relaxed you can get your legs and your feet. Just let them go completely limp. And then leave your left leg relaxed and straight, and bring your right foot up somewhere between your knee and your thigh. You decide. Maybe it's lower. And then keep that left leg relaxed and ground through your sit bones. So feel the mat under your sit bones. And then bring your arms overhead. You're trying to get length from your sit bones to just under your arm, but you can use your hands, your arms, your wrists to get some length. But keep that left leg relaxed, keep that right leg relaxed too. And when you feel as though you've gone as high as you can, drop your shoulders and then your own degree. And your own degree is going to be as far as you can up, and your left leg stays relaxed. It's in no way a competition. Your face doesn't need to touch your leg. Just become dead weight. Your arms relax. We're here for 3 minutes on each side. Just see if you can slip from doing into being. Just be. You'll notice that when you inhale, you remain aware of your breathing. Your chest and your torso expands, and when you exhale, it's an opportunity to deepen, but only to the degree that this left leg, left foot stays relaxed. And you've always got that affirmation on the exhale presence. shoulders go. One more minute. Use your breathing as an anchor to ground you. And when thoughts come, label them, let them go. It's one of the most valuable things you can do for your mind is to become aware of where your thoughts go. Are you stuck in the past? Which is typically regret and guilt? Or does your mind move to the present, which is often worry and fear? And now when you rise back to seated, just walk your hands up, vertebrae at a time. Bring your right leg back. You can kind of shake it out. And allow your right leg to relax. And then bring your left foot up, somewhere between your knee and your thigh. See if you can balance your sit bones so you're not leaning on one more than the other. And then while keeping this right leg relaxed, bring your arms above your head and see how much length you can get from your sit bone to just under your arm, but use your wrist, your arms in order to get there. And then drop your shoulders and fold from your waist. And come back to your breathing. Keep that right leg, right foot relaxed. So one of the reasons that you want to do this is this pose, half butterfly, when you stay in it long enough, it becomes a yin pose. And in yin, the oldest form of yoga, in yin, we want to hold a pose in a relaxed surrender for at least 90 seconds. Because the first 90 seconds in a stretch, you're stretching the muscle. And after 90 seconds, if you can allow yourself to relax, you not only stretch the muscle, but you access the connective tissue under the muscle. And so why would you want to access that connective tissue? You want to do it because as we age, that connective tissue starts to atrophy. It becomes really brittle and stiff, which is one reason why older people, when they break a bone or have joint stiffness, it's that connective tissue that has hardened around it. Yin yoga will send fluid to the connective tissue and return it to your youthful self. That's why they call it the fountain of youth. So you're breathing into your back. One more minute. Let go. You can keep returning to that affirmation of presence. Drop that pearl on the exhale. Watch the ripple of stillness on the inhale.
complicate things by worrying that it's difficult for you, because stillness itself is an advanced practice. Most of us just aren't used to it. Now, when you rise back up to seated, crawl your hands and rise a vertebrae at a time. And then come down into child's pose. So you want big toes together. Your knees can be together or as wide apart as you need or want. But become very grounded in your heels. And bring your arms, your very relaxed arms, next to you and kind of rest the tops of your hands. If your hands don't touch the floor, it is probably because your arms aren't as long as my arms and my daughter Hannah, who inherited my long arms. So it's okay if your arms don't touch, you just want them to dangle. And when you feel very grounded in your heels, fold. And let go. So that your arms and your shoulders are like wings of a bird. And you just open them up like a bird falling asleep in the nest. We'll stay here for about 3 minutes. You're breathing down on your back body. So it's as though you could breathe through the top of your head all the way down your spine and then exhale right back up. And then bring your arms out in front of you. Go ahead and stretch them. See if you can keep your sit bones nestled in your heels. So when your sit bones come up, even if they don't nestle in your heels, see if you can press back with your hips. And then bring your right hand to the right corner of the mat at an angle. And then bring your head with you and claw your left hand. If you could draw your left hand over on top of your right. In other words, getting a stretch here from your left sit bone to your left pinky. And breathe down your back. Just notice the different ways that your body moves when you breathe. Relax your hips. And then crawl back to center. And then bring your left arm at an angle over toward the left corner of your mat. And crawl your right hand, your head over toward, see if you can bring your right hand on top of your left. And feel that stretch on your right side. And bring down your back body. And then come back to center. Bring your hands apart and come up to tabletop. Tuck your toes under and we will move into your first down dog. So one good thing about doing down dog at home is that no one can police your down dog or grade it. So one thing that you can do in down dog, because the ultimate goal is to press down through your heels and press back with your hips, one thing that you can do is to take what's called a wider dog. You can even bring your feet off of the mat. You can bring them as far apart as you like. And what's called a shorter dog. See if either of those modifications can invite your heels to the mat. If not, it's okay. And then bring your feet back to the center of the mat. And on an inhale, bring your right leg up to three-legged dog. And on an exhale, swing to the top of the mat. And we'll go into a few lunges. So here, come forward, bring your chin and your head up. And as you press back with that left heel, bring your right toes up. So it's kind of like a cat-cow. We'll do that three times. Relax that left foot, by the way. So come forward on an inhale. Bring your face up, get a good stretch. And as you come back toward that left heel, bring the right toes up. And we'll do it one more time. And then bring your right leg back and your back and down dog. See if you can press your hips back. And then on an inhale, bring your left leg up. And on an exhale, swing it forward. And inhale. This is like our cow. And press back through that right heel and bring your right toes up. Bring your chin to your chest. Two more like that. Inhale. Come forward. Exhale. Arch your back. Chin to chest. One more. Forward. And then back. And now step your right foot forward. And we'll do a few forward folds and then flat backs. So make little relaxed fists with your hands and just rest them in your elbows and hang. Sometimes if you get a tiny bend in your knees, you can feel your lower back release. Your weight is in your heels, you're grounded. So you can feel, in fact, just mentally scan the bottoms of your feet. Notice that every part of your feet are touching, but your grounding is in your heels. Exhale, on an inhale, flat back. So you're looking for a flat back, and you're looking for as much length as you can get from the top of your head to your tailbone. And then exhale, forward fold. We'll do this two more times. Inhale, flat back. Keep your weight in your heels. Exhale, fold. One more time. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. And now bring your hands to your hips, grounding through your heels, kind of ragdoll your body up. So we're going to come into 7 half sun salutations. And we'll do them slowly. It'll be a moving meditation. So you want your feet wherever you feel stable. So the most advanced way to do half sun salutations would be with your feet together. A lot of people feel really stable in half sun salutations when their feet are about 2 fists apart, give or take. So you're here in mountain. Bring your shoulders back. And notice that your weight is in your heels, almost as though someone has staked your heels through the ground. And you will rise on an inhale and dive on the exhale.
back, a little back bend. Mine kind of naturally does that, Hannah's doesn't. So do what feels right to you. Inhale, rise. Exhale, dive. A moving meditation.
Inhale.
Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rise with the stability of your hamstrings. Exhale, trace your thumbs down the center of your face. Inhale, rise and fly. Exhale, dive.
Inhale, dead weight.
Inhale, flat back, top of your head, far away from your tummy. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rounding through your heels. Stability in your ears. Exhale back to center. Two more. Inhale, rise and fly. Exhale, dive. Inhale, flat back. Try to become dead weight. Exhale. Now from where you are, bring your right foot out to a straddle. And if you'd like to stay on your mat, it's not too complicated. Just turn your left foot and bring your right foot over. So whichever you want. And now you're in that forward fold, but in a straddle. So now crawl your hands over to your right leg. See what you can catch with your right leg. Maybe it's your right ankle. Maybe it's your right thigh. See what you can catch. And then bring your right arm up to the sky for triangle. Your weight is still in your heels. And then bring your right arm down. Stop here at the center and crawl over to your left leg. See what you can catch with your right arm and then bring your left up to the sky. And then come back up to center. Bring your hands to your waist and rise with the stability of your heels. And now we'll come into eagle arms. So turn your left foot toward the front of the mat and then step your right foot up. And you want your feet about hip width apart. And still, your stability is in your heels. Bring your shoulders back, relax your arms. And then bring both arms about shoulder height. And so reach and then let them relax. Bring your right elbow on top of your left and see if you can get a twist. Some people like to hold on to their thumb. Some people bring palms together. Again, this is a function of the length of your arms. So here in eagle arms, what we're targeting is your upper back and your shoulders. If you have a death grip on anything or you feel like you're too, holding too tightly, see what you can relax. Just about 20 more seconds. Release your arms down and bring your shoulders back because it feels good. Bring both arms up shoulder height. Bring your left elbow on top of your right. Twist. Bring your elbows out, up, and then relax. And see what you can relax. In other words, don't forget to become aware of your breathing. Bring both arms down. And we'll come into a standing twist. So you can keep your legs where they are, your feet where they are. Your stability is still in your heels. Bring both arms over your head and clasp your fingers and turn your palms up to the sky. See if you can get some length there. Just kind of alternate. The length isn't in your arms. This isn't about your arms. This is about length from your sit bones to under your arms. So from here, rotate toward the right and then up toward the sky. Now your body, your shoulders want to be tense and active, but tell them that this feels amazing. And they should relax. In other words, release your back. I just felt my release. And twist, come back to center. Turn toward your left, and then up. Bring your chest up to your own degree. First side's always easier than the second. Center, bring your arms down, and widen your stance. So bring your feet out a little bit more, and then angle your right foot toward the right corner of the mat, angle your left foot toward the left corner. Your weight is still in your heels and in your sit bones. I'm going to come down to a squat, so just imagine that something's pulling the base of your spine down to the floor. Here and squat, sometimes called garland. And we have a tendency to bring our weight forward, bring it back. Bring your palms together. And you now have basically the gas pedal for how much leverage, how deep you want to stretch in your inner thighs, because you can use your elbows to get there. You also want to bring your chest up. And then drop your chin just a little. Ideally, you find a place on the floor in front of you where your eyelids feel their most relaxed. And we'll be here for 2 minutes. So find that spot on the floor. See if you can go back to that affirmation of presence, the opportunity to focus on becoming present. It's between the repetition of that word presence that the mind becomes very, very still. behind you and kind of plop down. It's a good idea after squat to do windshield wipers. You want your palm, your fingers forward, otherwise you're rotating your shoulders. And then just alternate so you hear my left knees are going, my knees are going to the left and my shoulders going to the right. But don't overthink it. We'll just do this a couple of times. And then come back to staff. We'll come into caterpillar. And then sphinx. So you're here in caterpillar. Again, like in half butterfly, you want your legs to be very relaxed. So if they're active, your feet are pointing up and kind of toward each other. And if they're relaxed, and try to maintain that relaxation as you bring your arms over your head and see if you can get some height without compromising the relaxation in your legs. See if you can get some height using your arms. And you've gone as high as you think you can go without engaging your legs. Drop your shoulders. We need to stay here. We need to stay here for 4 minutes. Your arms, your shoulders, it doesn't matter where your arms are, as long as your shoulders are relaxed and your arms are dead weight. Because someone picks them up and just fall back down. So you don't need to reach for anything. That's the thinking mind, is saying reach, go farther. Even though we're folded forward, you still have maximum lung capacity along your back body. You can breathe in through the top of your head, all the way down to the base of your spine. Just relaxing every muscle in your back. And exhale, presence right out the top of your head. Come and they always will. Notice, is this a thought in the past or in the future? Become aware of that and let it go. It's been 2 minutes, so even though this pose is really targeting the connective tissue along your back and along your spine, you are getting, you're kind of double dipping by getting all the connective tissue along your legs and your feet. And that's what you're probably feeling right now, is maybe some numbness or tingling, maybe like your legs are falling asleep. That is natural, and as in anything in yoga, unless it's pain, you're fine. You shouldn't experience pain, any kind of sharp pain. But it is a numbness. Kind of a tingling. Seconds.
You might be interested to know that they polled thousands of yogis and asked them to name the five most important yoga poses in all of yoga, of which there are countless. And this pose made the top five. And now when you come back up to staff, you will rise a vertebrae at a time. And that's when you'll notice that you just stretched your back. Come down onto your belly for the cow pose, caterpillar, which is Sphinx. So the tops of your feet are flat. You want your elbows under your shoulders and keep them pretty close to your chest. So I would say a common mistake is for people to bring their elbows out, and now you put stress on your shoulders. And we don't want stress at all. So, elbows under your shoulders, about a 90-degree angle, and very relaxed hands. Start the timer. Very relaxed hands. So, this is a chest opener, and also we want to get that little stretch at the base of our spine. So to do that, keep your elbows where they are. Pull back on your forearms and forward with your chest. Kind of need your lower belly area. I'll call it. You need to get there. Something that rhymes with pubic bone. And then the bottom of your chin is parallel to the floor. And once you feel like it's parallel to the floor, even if it's not, just imagine that it is, become aware of those bones in the back of your neck. And tip your chin until they feel neutral. So now you've tipped your chin just a little. And then find that place on the floor where your eyelids feel neutral and relaxed. That is known as your drishti, place for you to zone out and be present. And you're breathing into your belly. Just be present, try not to worry. Would you like a Buddha story?
Yes.
Oh, good. I was worried you'd say no. It is, this little Buddha tale is, I think, relevant for our times right now. Although I occasionally will say it in my yoga class, because I like it. So the Buddha was talking to his followers, to some people, and next to him was a boulder, a big boulder. And he asked the people he was talking to, his followers, how much they thought that boulder might weigh. And do you know what his followers said? It's really heavy. That will be really heavy. And the Buddha said, not if you don't pick it up. So maybe
good little lesson for these times. Maybe we just try not to pick anything up for now. And now you will lower your chest, trust me on this, a vertebrae at a time. And we will rest here
for about 30 seconds. And just breathe down your back. For one thing, it feels good. For another, it keeps you aware and present. And that's what we're trying to do here. All you ever have is now. And then bring your hands next to your chest and tuck your toes under and come up to tabletop. And we'll go into cat-cow as a moving meditation just for about 90 seconds. So you're here in tabletop and you want to feel the entirety of your palms, like starfish your hands are. And your feet are relaxed and your back is relaxed. And on an inhale, drop your belly and your face comes forward, and you want to know your forehead as far from your sit bone as you can get it. A little decompression of the spine. And it's perfect after the caterpillar and sphinx that we just did, because the cow mimics sphinx, that back bend. And when your body is ready to exhale, arch your back, come into cat, your chin comes to your chest, and imagine that your tailbone kind of dips forward toward you. And when you notice that your body starts to inhale, drop back into cow. And we'll just do a few of these to kind of stretch out what we just did. But try to move after you notice your body breathing rather than before. Just a couple more. And now from here, we'll go into thread the needle. So maybe bring your hands just a little bit closer and your dead weight. And then bring your right arm up, watch your right hand, and then thread it through and collapse. Your bottom half is kind of in puppy. This is targeting that right shoulder. We won't stay here long. And then bring your left hand next to your face. And bring your left hand to the sky, left arm, get a little bend, thread it through. And this should be kind of a sigh because we're almost in Shavasana. Matter of fact, my favorite pose in all of yoga is next. Guess what it is now?
Happy baby.
How did you guess that?
I don't know. You like happy baby.
How did you guess that?
Huh?
And then bring your right hand next to your face and come back up, and we'll go into happy baby. So you come down
onto your mat. And bring your knees into your chest. Hug and squeeze your knees into your chest. And see if you can kind of release your lower back. And then bring your knees outside of your chest and your feet up to the sky. And your hands, some people bring them to the insides. I like the outsides. This is an ideal for a happy baby. If your hands don't want to make friends with the bottom of your feet, you can bring your elbows behind your knees, kind of clasp your hand around your wrist, and no matter what you're doing, you want your shoulders relaxed as though someone's pushing them toward the floor. As though something's pulling them through the floor, and in fact pulling you through the floor. Dead weight, your arms are dead weight. You can sway side to side. This is a very healing pose, really good for your lower back. So I just noticed my right foot was tense, and I just relaxed it and I felt my lower back release. This pose is instinctive to humans. You did it when you were a baby and your parents thought, oh, he or she loves to play with their feet. But actually, it is an instinctive pose to get you vertical, to stretch your hamstrings, thighs, groin, hip flexors, arms, core, knees. Shoulders. So about 20 seconds more. Unless you want to hobble around in your old age, do happy baby. And now bring your knees into your chest. And find your Shavasana. So maybe your Shavasana is on your mat, kind of compact. The yin version of Shavasana is what's called pinnacle or star pose. So you bring your legs and arms out as far from your extremity as possible. Kind of go to a 10 and then drop. And we're going to go into a guided meditation called passive progressive relaxation, which I do a lot after yin classes. People seem to like it. We'll see if Hannah falls asleep. So here in Shavasana, find a comfortable position with your eyes closed and become heavy. Surrender as though something is pulling you through the floor, because something is. It's a little thing we call gravity. This is a guided meditation known as passive progressive relaxation. And know that meditation is simply practicing focusing on your breathing. It's simple and yet it's complex. And it's complex because we find it difficult to cultivate stillness and then to remain still. And that's what makes most people abandon meditation. And when they abandon it, then a lot of times they convince themselves that it's not important. But it is. So when thoughts come during meditation, don't make a personal problem out of it. Don't overthink it. In fact, don't think it at all. Go back to your breathing. So focus on the breath. Invariably, thoughts will come, and you return to the breath. So now, become aware of your breathing. Focus on slowing down the rhythm of your breathing. Your chest and abdomen will expand outward with each breath, gently filling with air. Imagine your rib cage moving out to the sides when you inhale, and then moving gently inward as you exhale. And slowly take a deep breath in. Pause for a moment at the top of your inhale, and then exhale slowly and fully, allowing the tension to melt away as you relax more deeply with each breath. And now turn your attention to the top of your head. The top of your head. Feel the relaxation beginning at the top of your head and spreading slowly downward. Even your ears are becoming relaxed and heavy. Feel your eyebrows resting. Gently resting downward. Notice your forehead is becoming relaxed and smooth. Allow your temples to relax. Let your jaw relax by allowing your mouth to be slightly open. Allow your tongue to relax. Feel your throat relaxing. Relax your cheeks, your nose, and your eyes. Notice your eyelids becoming very heavy and very relaxed. More and more. Now bring your attention to your neck and allow a feeling of relaxation and letting go to begin at the top of your neck, flowing downward. Feel the relaxation and letting go as your shoulders become relaxed and loose. Let your shoulders gently sink downward as they become relaxed and heavy. Very heavy and very relaxed. Deeper and deeper relaxed. Feel your collarbones becoming relaxed as your shoulders move gently back and your chest widens and expands. Allow all the muscles in your shoulders to feel smooth and relaxed as the muscles in your shoulders give up their hold completely. Notice your breathing once again. See how regular it has become. Continue to take slow, smooth, deep breaths. Breathe in the feeling of relaxation. breathe in peace. And breathe out any tension. Because it is through your breathing that you become more and more relaxed, deeply relaxed. Now turn your attention to your right arm. Feel the relaxation flowing down your right shoulder. Allow your upper arm to relax. Your elbow, your lower arm, and your wrist become loose and relaxed. Enjoy this feeling of letting go as all of the muscles of your right arm give up their hold. Feel the relaxation flowing into your hand. Let all tension drain out each fingertip and flow away. The relaxation spreads to your thumb, out your index finger, down your middle finger, through your ring finger, and little finger. Feel the relaxation flowing down your left arm. Let the muscles of the left upper arm relax. Relax your elbow, your lower arm, and your wrist. Feel the relaxation flowing all the way down your left arm. Let the tension melt away. Imagine the tension flowing right out your fingertips. And allow your left hand to relax completely. Relax your thumb, index finger, middle finger, ring finger, and little finger. Both of your arms are now totally relaxed. As you continue to focus on your breathing, become aware of your chest and stomach. And feel the relaxation there, becoming deeper with each breath. Imagine your heart resting in your back body and feel it becoming heavy. Now turn your attention to your upper back. Feel the relaxation flow down your spine. Let every muscle give up their hold. Relax your upper back, your middle back, and your lower back. Allow your entire back to relax completely. And now feel the relaxation in your entire upper body. Relax even more deeply with each breath, more and more relaxed, deeply relaxed and calm. Now let your hip muscles relax. Relax all the way from your hips, all the way down the back of your thighs. Relax the muscles on the front of your thighs. And feel the relaxation in your upper legs moving down to your knees, your calves, and your shins, your ankles, and your feet. Allow all the muscles to relax and let go. Allow any tension to flow right out the soles of your feet. And feel this relaxation flowing through your entire body from the top of your head, down, all the way down to the bottom. breath. And each time a thought interrupts, return to your breath. Feet to the mat so that your knees are pointing to the sky. And bring your knees into your chest. And then bring your arms out to a T with your palms down. And then become very aware of your right palm, right forearm, right elbow, right upper arm, right shoulder, pressed into the floor. Become very aware of that surface. As you allow your knees to fall to the left, see if you can keep your arm, your right arm, where it is without moving at all. And then turn your face toward your right hand. And think of someone you're grateful for, not something. And then bring your knees back up and become very aware of your left palm touching the floor, left forearm, left elbow, left upper arm, left shoulder, grounded, heavy. As you allow your knees to fall to the right, see if you can keep your left arm perfectly still. And turn your face toward your left hand to complete the twist. And send yourself some love. Relax your belly, relax your legs. Take a deep breath. Bring your left arm over. So you're now in fetal position on your right side. Take an inhale and then the exhale, press your left hand into the floor and come up to seated and we'll start right where we began. Thank you for joining us today. I hope that you were able to forget any troubles or stress that you have.